Anyone who's worked with you or around you knows how much importance you give to empathy and joy and kindness. Is it difficult to be an empathetic leader and also an astute business person?
I strongly do believe that they're not mutually exclusive. No, they're not. You know, in fact, I think the fact that, you know, when we are at work, there is a reason why we're here. There's a reason why we're doing something. You know, I think intellect, curiosity, passion, these are things that make us different from robots, right? Otherwise, we would just sort of design a world of robots and let them run it, and they would also perhaps do a large part of it. I just feel that the value connectedness creates is just longer lasting. It's sustainable. Never ever has a business failed because it was high empathy or it was high joy or it had a, you know, purpose that took it towards. I think we fail because we either become inauthentic or we maybe not doing the logically right thing. You know, you can't go against principle of economics and principles of gravity and principle of customer care. There is a whole lot of logic to it. Yeah. It's so yin and yang that you can't do one without the other. You need both. You know, and I totally believe that, like even when we, you know, look at so many sort of ways, you know, so many things at Sheroes itself.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people assume that we might be losing out, we might be inefficient, or we might not be sort of, you know, creating the value. But the fact remains that value is generated in more ways than one. In the goodwill of the business, in the quality of people who want to work with you, the commitment that people have with you, the quality of connection you create within your own community, you know, and there's no amount of money that can change that.
And loyalty, I think we don't accord it enough importance.
Absolutely.
Like loyal employee basis.
Absolutely. Yeah. And also the fact that, you know, everybody knows that, you know, this is not a place that induces anxiety in them. I mean, I think a lot of pain in the corporate world is because they become anxiety-inducing atmospheres, right? And have we ever calculated the cost of anxiety, the cost of stress, the cost of, you know, being non-humane workplaces? You know, I think that cost is way higher than we can ever calculate.
Absolutely.
You know, and I think ultimately we got to put human beings at the center of it, right? And I think somewhere we keep forgetting it and we got to sort of go back to that.
You were talking about your daughter earlier,
yeah.
And we all, I think, struggle with the same issues in terms of how all our children have so much.
Yeah.
If there's one lingering sort of financial message or principle you want her to hold on to, and indeed young children these days, what would it be?
Yeah, I think it would be very simple that you got to earn it. You know, it's lucky, you know, we're lucky that we have enough. It's lucky that, you know, we don't have to sort of struggle too much, but you know, struggling a little bit creates confidence. You know, it's like sports training.
The you stress, right? It's just that little bit.
Yeah. If you get the right kind of struggle, it turns you into gold, right? Otherwise, that opportunity never arises. So you know, so earning and working hard at something, earning whatever you have, you know, so whether it is, you know, your next vacation or, you know, whatever you want to do. And I think there's a lot of peer pressure on kids to say, you know, so X and X got an iPhone and so went for a vacation. I just stand up later and tell my daughter, I don't have the money. You know, you want it, you please earn it. Or you do something that will make it happen, right? So she hears no's all the time. And the ability to take rejection. The fact is we're going to always be rejected. We're going to fail. We're going to fail in more places than we can ever imagine. And, you know, and it's all right. Money or only, you know, your financial success can't be, it can't be tied to your own self-esteem, you know. And I think that's really important. So, you know, there are other ways to sort of diffuse that, to sort of introduce other ways to, you know, make this a bigger, more wholesome conversation.
Yeah.
But with my daughter, I'm very clear that you got to earn it. You will get your basics, you know, and of course, once she's 18, I'm going to tell her that.
Kindly wing it alone.
Yeah, on your own, you know, if you get stuck, call me, but, you know, it's not on a platter.